Glowforge tutorials, also 616 SBG and Forge Notions. I'm doing a little how-to video or project idea, depending on how you want to look at it, for some pieces I got from Michaels and products I made on the Glowforge. Depending on how long this takes, I might have to do a two-part video because I have an internet doctor's appointment at 3 o'clock. They're going to call me at 2:50 to get that set up because of the COVID virus. Can't go to the doctor's office. Anyway, I got these, the 5-pack. At Michaels. They are Artwood cradle board. These ones are 8x10 and they're pretty sturdy. I'm going to be putting a link up on my group for a free file, so I'm going to start making that one first. Which is this product here. So let me get all my pieces ready for that one. So I have my board, which I'm going to leave white for this project. A moon. It does appear to be backwards. 3 stars, which I'm going to secure with fishing line. And then I have 4 circles that I'm going to glue together to raise the back of the moon to give it a little depth. And then the stars can be floating instead of glued to the board. So first I need to start by using my tools. I got a 5-pack, they're kind of like dental tools. These are the only two I know of right second. I got these from onesourcesupply.com. They are also located in Michigan, up by Flint in Grand Blanc. No, Grand something. It might be Grand Blanc. I know how to get there. I don't know where I'm going, but I know how to get there. So I started this project. I pre-painted the moon because it is engraved and it looks better, in my opinion, to pre-paint it before you cut and engrave and score if you paint it ahead of time. The stars are either unpainted wood or cut from a scrap piece I had. I don't remember which, because I actually cut these the other day, but with the whole world being the way it is, it's just been weird and I haven't had a chance to sit down and do these videos. So anyway, you can sit here and pick and pick and pick, or I take this scraper. It says Oracle right here. It's a vinyl tool. These are also used for vinyl tools. But if you already work with vinyl and you switch over or add the Glowforge to your arsenal of machinery / tools, a lot of the accessories coincide with each other. Anyway, you can just scrape that masking tape right off all your little grave spots. So I don't know if you noticed how long it was taking me, but I used the scraper and now I'm done. So the words are engraved, as you can see, And then I have a couple of stars that are cut out. And then I have a couple of stars that are scored. And then I gotta remove the paper backing. My masking tape, this particular batch, came from the Vinyl Spectrum. I bought it in late 2019. I choose the Vinyl Spectrum for quite a few things when I want to pick up locally. They are located 5 to 10 minutes from my husband's work, so he's able to pick them up there. It was $40 for a 12 by 300 foot roll. However, it has come to my attention that they raised the price from $40 to $50. So now I will be purchasing that from the one source supply as well, because they were cheaper to begin with, but then you gotta factor in shipping time. I'll just plan accordingly. So now I'm going to be doing the stars, which do need painted, so I'll have to slap some paint on those real quick. They do not have holes in the top and bottom because I plan to do them all where they float, again using the fishing line. And I plan to do the fishing line like I'm tying a hook to my fishing line. And I will teach you how to do the fisherman's knot if you do not know how already, because it's easy and I know how. So that's how I'm gonna do it. Plus, I don't know if you can tie fishing line any other way. I have never attempted to. In fact, many years ago, I used fishing line to secure my Christmas tree because it was leaning a little, and I put some screws in my wall and wrapped fishing line around the pole of my tree and secured it, again using the fisherman's knot. I am using yellow for the stars. You could get creative and make prettier colored ones, or make a black background and make them a white. Some stars are really white and not yellow, but I did not feel like doing all that. So anyway, this is just plain acrylic paint. I'm gonna slap it on there. These are a little bit bigger than I want to use this paintbrush for. So I'm gonna use this, the cosmetic wedge. Came from the Dollar Tree. You can get 28 of these for, guess what, a dollar. Now just slap that on there. These are gonna take a couple of coats, but this acrylic paint on this wood dries in just a matter of minutes. So let's put it on thin and even. I do have wax paper down so I don't ruin my oak dining room table, because that would be horrible. I've had this table quite a long time. I bought it at Art Van for a dollar amount I won't disclose. And anybody who's local, before the COVID virus went viral across the internet, Art Van is going out of business. They declared bankruptcy and they screwed a lot of customers over with orders they had already had but would no longer fulfill. You could get a store credit, but if you didn't accept the store credit, you just lost your money and you had to shop by what they had in store. It was a big mess. I think I am going to do these two-sided since they will be floating on the board and not glued. The backs will be visible. So I'm going to go ahead and slap that on there. I'm going to take off my glasses because it's hard for me to see up close with my glasses on. Now I can't see my screen, but I'm supposed to have bifocals, but I don't. If it will stand so it can dry evenly. All right, I'll just prop it. I do tap the paint in corners or edges so you don't have a lot of paint that rolls off the edge. With the Glowforge, you end up with a nice black edging, and I prefer the black edging on most projects. So I try not to get the paint to go over the black edging. And like I said, this paint dries super fast, especially when you don't cake it on. Got a little bit on the edge, so let's take a clean spot of my sponge. Like I said, this file will be available for free, and we'll have to put a link up on the group page for Dropbox or something. I'll do that after my doctor's appointment. First one. These will only need two coats, not three. I'm using this tool to get a little bit of the paint out of the circle, the hole. And with a star shape, it doesn't matter which side is front or back, because there's no right or wrong in a star. If it were an item that has a definite front versus a definite back, then it would be different. good enough. All right, so now I'm gonna do these spacers. Paint off my tool. And if you'll notice, this one has a hook. I don't know if you can see that. There you go. Makes it really easy to peel all the masking tape off of the wood. This particular material is 1/4 inch MDF from the Home Depot. I get a lot of my wood supplies from Home Depot. They sell online and in store. They do have a much better selection online. And you can do a search on Home Depot. In the search bar, you can use the search for Glowforge, and it will bring up materials that are suitable for the Glowforge. Or you can do another keyword search by using the term custom cut, and you'll get a lot of the same materials plus a few more that way. So I think I'm going to place these here. Just want to see how I like it. I'm going to bring these closer to me with my T-Rex arms. I'm going to glue these together real quick before I try to adhere them to that. Just using a little tube of E6000. Now, in my office, I forgot to bring it out here. I do have what I call a glue board, and in the next video, I'll make sure I have that. This is where I take the glued piece and I just kind of go like this on the glue board to disperse the glue evenly so it doesn't leave a lot of glued pieces. But this won't make it much of a difference because of how I'm going to be applying it. Just hold this tight for a few minutes. And then I have, bear with me a moment. Normally I just use a toothpick, but those are on the other side of the kitchen. So I'm going to use a popsicle stick and clean up some of this glue on the edges, or even just spurt it around. Like I said, this part will not be very visible. There. Now I'll do this one. And I came in, I don't know if you, I had one glob of glue there. I kind of came in and I'm going to spread it, give it a little twist to make sure all the glue is even and you don't have one big glob on the left side and the right side has nothing. So, in hindsight, I should have done this before I did anything else. I'm going to give those a chance to dry. So now while I'm letting those dry, I will get the fishing line going. I'm gonna cut them a little longer than I need to because I can shorten them up after applying them. Do not ask me why I put my glasses back on because I can't see. Alright, so we're going to lace that through there. And for a fisherman's knot, you take, you're not going to be able to see this, but I'm going to walk you through it. You take your cut end and loop it around three times. I do like to do, and I forgot to do, because quite frankly, I haven't been fishing in 2 years. Is put my finger, put an extra finger there, because I'm gonna need to go through this loop, the first loop. So I usually put my finger there, so I don't have to go, for lack of a better term, fishing for it later. So we got one, two, three, four. So now I'm going to take the cut end and go through this hole here where my finger is. Remove my finger and pull tight. Okay. Now I will cut off the cut end. Happens here. Remember, I want to cut this longer than it needs to be so I don't have to redo the whole thing. I can adjust the length once I tie it to the moon. So we'll just cut it there. Alright, so we got this one. And then lather, rinse, repeat for the other two. Going the wrong way. Gonna go look to see what time it was, and I have no idea where my phone is. I don't know why I even bother using my left hand sometimes. First loop. Nope, that doesn't count. First loop. Now put my finger there. Start over. One. Do one more because I'm not sure that one took. I can't see what I'm doing. I'm still recording.
How long is this gonna take?
A while. Do you see my phone sitting anywhere?
No.
Did you look for it? Cause I seem to have misplaced it. Alright, don't worry about it. What time is it?
2:33.
Hmm?
2:33.
Okay. Alright, one more stir. Alright, so these are ready to go. I'm going to get these on here before it's glued to the board. Go this direction. I'm going to do the same thing up here. Hopefully I left enough room. I'll make this the short one. Okay. Cut off a little bit. I think it's too long. And then basically we're repeating the same steps as making the knots on the stars. Okay, that's not as short as I wanted it to be, so that might be the middle one. So, it's going to be approximately there. Wish me luck on this one. Oh, that that shortened it up a little bit. Okay, we will have to continue this later.